this on some cartoon show or heard about it sometime or another. An opera singer hits a high note and shatters all the glass in sight. But is this actually possible? I mean, can the human voice really shatter glass? Well, to get to the answer, we conducted our own little experiment. This isn't working. So can the human voice shatter glass, or is this some myth? Well, theoretically, it can. But in order to shatter glass with the human voice, we need to do a couple of things. The first thing we need to do is establish the natural frequency of the glass. And that's as easy as... When you flick the glass, it vibrates. The glass, in turn, vibrates the air molecules around it. The vibrating air molecules then travel into your ear and vibrate your eardrum. You perceive all these vibrations as that ringing sound, which is the glass's natural frequency. So, the natural frequency of the glass is just the number of times it vibrates back and forth when you strike it. Using some measuring equipment, we determined one of this glass's natural frequencies to be around 700 hertz. Hertz is a measurement of how many times something vibrates in a second. So this glass vibrates back and forth about 700 times in 1 second. Okay, so we've established the natural frequency of the glass. But why is that so important? Well, if you can reproduce that frequency, you can actually get this glass to vibrate without even touching it. Let me show you what I mean. I've got two identical tuning forks here. Now, I'm going to make this tuning fork ring by using this tuning fork way over here. Watch. Now, listen to this one. When the tuning fork is struck, it sends out sound vibrations whose frequency precisely match the natural frequency of the second tuning fork. The vibrations cause the second fork to vibrate until it begins to ring. This effect is called resonance.
Resonance is like swinging someone on a swing. With only a few small pushes, you can get the person swinging through quite a large arc. Now, you're able to do this because you time your pushes to match the swing's natural frequency, the rate at which it naturally moves back and forth.
The same principle is at work with the tuning forks, or when your car begins to rattle at a certain speed, or when certain objects vibrate and buzz in response to a particular note from your stereo. These are all everyday examples of resonance. Resonance has also been responsible for some spectacular destruction. In earthquakes, buildings are often damaged when the frequency at which the ground is shaking matches one of the natural frequencies of the buildings themselves. The Tacoma Narrows Bridge in Washington vibrated itself to pieces back in 1940 when a strong wind pushed it at just the right frequency. Across a bridge out of step, and army vehicles are spaced at irregular intervals. These practices avoid setting up vibrations at the bridge's natural frequency. So in theory, if we can precisely reproduce the natural frequency of this glass, we can get it to vibrate to a point where it will eventually shatter. To test our theory, we enlisted the services of a professional resonator, a trained singer. We had her listen to the natural frequency of the glass, then had her take a crack at it, so to speak. Nothing. So what's going on? In theory, this should have worked, right?
Well, do you remember our swing analogy? Well, you may be able to match the natural frequency of the glass, but because of its rigid nature, it takes an enormous amount of sound energy just to get the thing moving. Upwards of 130 decibels.
That's about 30 times more intense than a jet engine. You'd be hard-pressed to find someone with that kind of raw vocal power. But we can get around that obstacle with this, an amplifier. With amplifier in hand, we gave it another try. But this time, we recorded the singer. Then we set the glass in front of the amplifier and a loudspeaker. We played back the frequency, added the necessary volume, and presto, the glass shattered. The first thing we need to do is establish.
That's a blooper for you, Caroline, because you can't find too many, so here's a blooper.
Oops, I can't believe I messed up my line.
Okay.